profession because of the way that people are being paid. Has that affected you as well and affected others in your circles?
Music industry has always been very difficult and more tough to navigate than even politics, I would say. I've been paid by BMI through my own performance of songs. Mm-hmm. There's always a glass ceiling in everyone's career, you know, and mine was performing as an independent mm-hmm. artist, you know. And I've been definitely, you know, think that it was very disparaging as I watched the music industry crumble, mm-hmm. that the idea that we were going to be able to make money independently using the internet just disappeared. Suddenly it was, you know, bought up by big media conglomerates and kept, you know, under wraps by big music industry executives, mm-hmm. which, you know, it's fine. You know, it's just, if you're not on a label, you're not getting the exposure. And that's not something that I really need to discuss politically, but the truth for me is that performing was where I made my money. Mm-hmm. Performing is where I've always made my money, and selling my own hard copies of CDs and merchandising is where I've made my money.
Now, do you still perform?
Not as much as I used to, but yeah, occasionally. Mm-hmm. You know, I started playing with a gospel church band at Howard Jones's congregation, so that's something I'll be doing regularly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what are other qualities in talking about skill sets that you bring that could make you a successful vice mayor?
Personability, the ability to communicate with groups of people, varying groups of people, knowing, having a sense for what, you know, having my finger on the pulse of the city, feeling that, not being part of, you know, not being part of the elite, not coming from the same place that everybody in the council, not everybody, but some of the members of the council come from, and perhaps the mayor comes from it. Bringing a perspective in that is in tune with middle class and poorer parts of town, and helping get, yeah, just doing some common sense stuff that would really go a long way to help residents of the city, like a tablet program for the mm-hmm. schools. We can afford to pay teachers more, but we can also modernize our schools and save money. This idea that it would cost more money to modernize the schools than it would to do it is somebody clinging onto some old ideas. The truth is the kids can operate the tablets better than some of the teachers can. And we just need to get the teachers on board with teaching in the 21st century. It's 2018, and the technology is so inexpensive. And we just need to be preparing the kids for the future that they're going to be living in.
So this being, is this your first campaign?
This is my very first campaign, yeah.
So what has surprised you, disappointed you, maybe pleased you?
I have no comment.
All right. And in terms of what you're hearing from people, you know, aside from affordable housing, what else are people telling you that they want you to do?
Well, you get a lot of crazy people, crazy requests from people sometimes, and so, you know, I've been known for saying some stuff on the internet, and I just want to let people know that that's kind of a side of me that is comical. So sometimes it gets lost in text translation, but people are just disenfranchised. They don't feel that the government is out for their benefit right now. You get the sense that they're out for themselves. You know, when you look at where their money is coming from, their financial disclosures, and you look at, you know, what parts of the city are getting attention, and the developers mm-hmm. are getting the better part of the deal here, not the residents of the city. Residents are getting the short end of the stick compared to the developers who are coming into the city to build it up. I just want to make sure that as we're building up the city, because we do have to, we have to build up the city, but as we're building up the city, we don't do it just to get rich. And, you know, when you're in the real estate business and you're handing out real estate contracts and development, then it's kind of a conflict of interest mm-hmm. in a way. You know, it's clear who you represent at that point. I haven't taken any money from developers. I've been running this campaign myself on $750. And, you know, if I get elected, it's because the people want me to be elected, and that will be the influence. That will be the special interest group that I'm looking out for, is the citizens and the residents of Davidson County. Yeah.
So as we look to conclude, is there anything that you'd like to say that we haven't talked about?
Not really. I hope if has anybody asked any questions?
No, people are watching, though.
Okay. Anybody got any questions out there?
Well, if we do have any questions, we're going to be concluding in just a few seconds. But if not, we'll certainly pass those questions along to you.
Okay.
And want to thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Matthew Del Rossi. And you go by Matt, correct?
Matt Del Rossi. Del Rossi. Yeah, and I do have a website, which is mattdelrossi.com. And also, I have the domain name matthewdelrossi.com. Which I did. I built myself in an hour for $5. Built my own website. That's what I'm talking about. My generation is ready to lead now, and we know how to do it very inexpensively.
Well, with that, we want to thank you very much, Mr. Del Rossi, and we want to thank the viewing audience. I'm David Plazas with the Tennessean. Best of success to you. And remember, everyone, it's early voting at this moment, which goes to the 28th, and you have August 2nd as the actual election. So please go vote.